My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, although I was already a student when Ninoy Aquino was shot at the tarmac of the airport, I belong to a generation who never saw him personally and never saw him alive in my whole lifetime. And probably many of us belong to that generation. Why? Because he was imprisoned for 7 years and 7 months during the days when I was a pupil, I was a student, I was growing up. Last night, I attempted to engage myself in a prayer conversation with the Ninoy Aquino, whom I never met. And I said to him in prayer, "Tomorrow, August 21st, we will remember how you were assassinated in the hands of powerful men at the airport as you were coming back home." And I was surprised to receive an answer in that prayer engagement. Ninoy seemed to ask me, "Which death? Which death? Aling kamatayan?" And I prayed over the question, which among those deaths are we celebrating? Because the reality, my dear brothers and sisters, is Ninoy did not only die on August 21st, 1983. He died many times before that. When he was arrested on September 22nd, 1972, something in him died. And imprisoned for 7 years and 7 months, almost all those years in solitary confinement, those were dyings every day. And when his family was searching for him and he could not be found because he had been put in solitary confinement in Laur, Nueva Ecija, it was dying. And when he was convicted of a crime that he never committed before a military tribunal, it was dying. It was dying to endure loneliness in solitary confinement because his only crime was he stood up for the truth and he wanted truth to be free. But then, my dear brothers and sisters, we who remember the death of Ninoy 39 years ago should also remember that the most beautiful lessons Ninoy learned in his lifetime, he learned in the many dyings before 1983. When did he learn the most important lessons? Was that when he was elected the youngest mayor or congressman or senator? Was it when he was the most popular among the opposition politicians? I guess not. Because the truth, my dear brothers and sisters, is success can give you victory. Success can lead you to victory. But only pain, only darkness, only daily dying can build character. And the most important lessons we learn in life, we learn not when we are successful and popular and feeling on top of the world. The most important lessons in life, we learn in solitary confinement, when faith was being tested, when the existence of God was being questioned, when friends were being far away and keeping safe, when family was so difficult to hug. Those times were difficult times, and those times were also the most fruitful times for learning the most important lessons in life. So, continuing my prayer engagement with our hero, I ask him, "Of course, your death on August 21st, But he seemed to smile at prayer as I imagined him looking at me and saying, "But when you pray, please say to the Lord, 'Lord, thank you that Ninoy died. Lord, thank you for the many dyings every day in those 7 months and 7 years, in those 7 years and 7 months. Thank you for the daily dying in solitary confinement, the lonely endurance in Laur, the trial before a military tribunal. All of these were dyings. And the most important lessons in heroism he learned in those dying, dark, critical, dry moments." That is what the Lord teaches us. Choose the narrow door. The narrow door is not very attractive. The narrow door is avoided by some. When you enter into a dark room, the first thing that you do is turn on the lights, because we don't like darkness. And when there are no lights to turn on in a dark room, the first thing that we do is to leave the room and look for light. It seems to be our nature to destroy darkness. It seems to be our nature to leave darkness because we want light. It is understandable, but there are only lessons darkness can teach, because an easy life, a successful life, a victorious life, a winning life, these are very bad, very poor teachers. And the lessons that easy living, comfortable living, convenient living teach us are lessons that drive us away from the path of the Lord. Righteousness in darkness, light in darkness, these are the lessons we remember today on August 21st. Today on August 21st, we renew our commitment that everything is passing and there will be judgment day, as the gospel tells us. There will be a day of reckoning. You can win in an election, but only truth tellers can win the gates of heaven. You can be rich by accepting bribes and not paying taxes, but only men and women of integrity have credibility to lead by example. You can allow the trolls to top you in the surveys, but only humble, selfless leadership can inspire. You can kill your opponents by a bullet, but only God can make the dead live forever. Maaari ninyong baguhin ang sulat ng kasaysayan, at maaari nating gawing bayani ang mga mandarambong. Subalit, walang lihim na hindi mabubunyag at hindi natutulog ang Diyos. My dear brothers and sisters, the family of Ninoy Aquino, President Cory, President Noy, would be the first to say that Ninoy Aquino was not a saint. He was not a saint, he was not a pious man. That is why we are praying for his soul. But there is something great in him that is worth remembering. And that greatness, I believe, can only come from God. Maybe he's not the pious Knights of Columbus that we have. Maybe he's not the pious extraordinary lay minister that we have. Maybe he's not the pious prayer leader that we have. But there is something greatness in him, because how can God not be in a man who willingly laid down his life so that freedom may be won and truth may be proclaimed? There is something great in him, and for that greatness, we thank the Lord. I am sorry that in my lifetime, I did not meet him in person. I was too young. I was only a boy, believe me. But the memory lives on, because that is the reward of being honest. That is the reward of being truthful. That is the reward of being selfless. That is the reward of standing up for freedom. You live forever, you are remembered forever, and you are set as an example for the others to follow. We pray for Ninoy Aquino, but we pray for our country. Our country needs heroes, and may all of you be those heroes.